It's been a good number of years since I've walked across this stage. And I think that's probably true with a number of them that are speaking here tonight. The school was built and completed in 1927. And it was built by the Honkin Conkin Company from Cleveland. They went by the nickname of Honky Conky. They had multiple problems in the construction of the school from the beginning till the end and years afterwards. And the biggest problem was getting rid of the surface water. They did not make arrangements to drain any of the surface water away. And consequently, this water flowed into the lower areas and down into what was the old gym, which was below what became a cafeteria on the lower floors. That was the first gym. And the reason we didn't start the school until October was because there was 4 feet of water in the gym and a couple feet of water in the furnace room. That continued for numerous years. We had to go to school on Saturdays to make up the time that we lost because we didn't start until October. I was asked, what is it like to go to school back in 1927? Well, we walked to school on dirt roads and we carried our lunch in a little paper bag because there were no buses and there were no cafeterias, but we got by very well without them. Fred Emery was the superintendent, and Mrs. Blanche Young was our first grade teacher. She was a local lady living right here in Hartville. And when I said Mrs. Blanche Young, they didn't hire married teachers back then at that time. But her husband died in World War I, and so she qualified to be a teacher for us. And she was a very good teacher. She was also my Sunday school teacher. And we started every morning with prayers, which is non-existent today, except in the parochial schools. As kids, we played outside, and we played with the waste material that came from the construction, because they did not pick up that material until months later after school started. There were boxes, and there were barrels, and all kinds of lumber. And we made little huts out of those at recess, and oftentimes at noon. And in the winter, we went skating on the pond at the far west end of the school playground, which later became a football field. That was a big pond at that time. We learned to read and write in the first grade because we didn't have preschool and we did not have the kindergarten. So we had to learn our reading and writing and the ABCs in the first grade. It wasn't unusual to find the kids wearing patched clothes to school because this was the beginning of what was called the Great Depression. And we found that you did what you had, you did with what you had. And the grain elevators, they sold animal feeds in cloth bags. And the mothers would make clothes out of those cloth bags for the children to wear to school. And some of the girls had on the back of their dresses Purina feeds. I think that we were perhaps a normal group of kids part of the time. And I was told that I was only supposed to speak for 3 minutes, so I'll sign off.